Finally tonight, why Lance Armstrong may be coming clean about not riding totally clean during his rise to the top of his sport.
We agreed that there would be no conditions.
Lance Armstrong's interview with Oprah Winfrey won't begin airing until tomorrow night, but reports that he's admitted to doping have already triggered strong reactions.
It's a long time coming.
Frankie Andreu was once close to Armstrong as a team captain of the U.S. Postal Service cycling team from 1998 to 2000.
I got emails.
But Andreu was ostracized after he and his fiance, now wife Betsy, testified in 2005 that Armstrong acknowledged using performance-enhancing drugs.
For my wife and I, you know, we've been attacked and ripped apart by Lance and all of his people and all his supporters repeatedly for a long time. And, you know, I just wish they wouldn't have been so blind and opened up their eyes earlier to all the signs that indicated that there was deception there so that we wouldn't have had to, you know, suffer as much. And it's not only us. I mean, he's ruined a lot of people's lives.
Regulators from the official bodies that police cycling are also speaking out. Head of the World Anti-Doping Agency, David Howman, has demanded Armstrong make his confession under oath. He told the Associated Press, he's got to follow a certain course, that is not talking to a talk show host. Armstrong vehemently denied doping for more than a decade, insisting he'd been tested hundreds of times and never failed a test. Now the International Cycling Union has commissioned an investigation into claims that positive test samples were hidden in exchange for money. For its part, the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency has already banned Armstrong for life, and it's pressing him now to name others involved in the long-running doping scheme on the Postal Service team. Meanwhile, Armstrong was out of sight today, said to be on his way to Hawaii.